It's hard to think of any game that's worth mentioning which doesn't make the use of buttons. Whether they're being used to navigate around menus, between scenes, to buy items at shops, count clicks, or progress dialogue, buttons are a cornerstone in video games. In a previous video, we went over how to create UI in Unity. In that video, we created some buttons, but didn't talk much about the button component or assign any functionality to them. In this video, we'll detail the button component and create two different functions for our buttons, one to change scenes and one to quit. I have my scene open here, and because I created my buttons in the last video on creating UI, I'm not going to go through that here. But if you want to know how to do that, feel free to check out that video. I'm going to navigate in my canvas to my buttons. Go to this play button here, and you can see this is where I have my button component attached. This first checkbox here is interactable. That means whether your button is clickable or not. Transition, there's a drop down here. I usually use color tint because of the way that I do my buttons. If you want to have different sprites for the different button states, you can do that as well. And there's also animations you can set up here if that's what you want to do. We're going to leave this set to color tint. Our target graphic is already correctly set because we created this button through Unity. It's set to this. The normal color is what your button will look like when it's not clicked or hovered over. Highlighted color is when you're hovering over the button. Press color is when you click. Selected color is after you've pressed, so it shows that it's been pressed. Disabled color is when your button is not interactable. The color multiplier is how strong these get applied. The fade duration is the length of time that the animation occurs between these color states. This navigation here, we won't go into too much detail about. It's basically for using a controller or your arrow keys to navigate the menus. I click visualize here, it'll show you sort of the states that you would press to get between the controller. So if I hit, if I had quit selected and I pressed up, it would go to play, and right, it would go to the settings. There's a really great video by Sam Yam. I'll link in the description down below if that's something you're interested in. The functionality of buttons really comes into play in this on click section. We're going to get into the details on that, but first we're going to create a new script. I'm going to navigate to my scripts folder. Right click in an open area, go to create, then find C# script and click that. I'm going to name this main menu. Then I'll double click so that it opens up in Visual Studio. Our script is open and we just need to do a little bit of housekeeping. We don't need either the start or the update function, so we can delete those, change some formatting. We're not going to use system collections or system collections generic here. We will be using the Unity engine. And then in addition to this, we'll also be using Unity Engine dot scene management. This is what we'll be using to switch between scenes. We're going to create two new functions, one to switch scenes and one to quit the app. We'll name the first one public void. Go to scene. And then it's going to take in a string. And the string will be the scene name. And then we're going to use the scene management function here called scene manager dot load scene. And then this is where the scene name will go. And we'll talk about more what this means when we get to the on click functions. But basically what's happening here is this has to be public so that it can be accessed by the button function. Void because we're not returning anything. Go to scene is just the name that we gave it. And then go to scene is taking in a scene name. And we'll be able to set this scene name through our button functionality. So we can attach this function to any button and just assign the scene name in the editor. The next thing we'll want to do is create the quit function. So public void quit app. This won't take any parameters. And then there is an application.quit function. When you're testing in the editor, this won't show anything because you can't quit out of the editor this way. So we put a debug log here that just says application has quit. And that's the script. Back in Unity, if we go to our button and the onClick function for that button, it says list is empty. If we click the plus here, this is really confusing. How do I get that those functions I just created? So the way that that works is that you have to attach an object that has the script that's referencing those functions. So what I like to do is attach that script to the upmost parent or the canvas, because that means that that will definitely be seen. So for instance, if I had different sort of menus or game objects in here that I was toggling on and off, it could get really confusing and I could lose that functionality if I attach it to a particular game object, like if you had different tabs or things like that. So I just like if I have sort of a generic function to attach it to the canvas. So to do that, I'm just going to drag and drop over here and I have that menu functionality. Now when I go to my play button, I want to drag my main canvas because that's where that script is attached. Drag my main canvas into this section. Now because my function is public, I'll be able to see it in this section. So under function, I can see main menu, which is my script. And there's a bunch of extra stuff in here that I'm not going to detail, but you can see that my go to scene and my quit app functions are available. If I assign the go to function for my play, you can see I get this little bar here, and that's where I can put my scene name. So for the play, I want to navigate to what's my scene called? Game. So put that in there, make sure that the capitalization is the same. And we can also use that function now in other places. Let's say we had a bunch of different levels and we had a menu that showed levels 1 through 10. You could, if you named those appropriately, you could just swap out the scene in this section for those specific level scene names. We'll go to the quit button and we'll add functionality here. Again, drag our main canvas so that we can access our main menu script. And then we're going to do quit app. Save my scene. Save my project. Now when I hit play, if I hit the quit button, you'll see that I get a debug log that says application has quit. Again, this only works in the actual application when you make a build. So that's why my application didn't close, but I do see this debug log, which is a good thing. And then when I hit play, you'll see that it navigates to my other scene. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, please don't forget to like and leave a comment down below. If you want more Unity tutorials just like this, hit subscribe. I'll leave a link in the description where you can go get the script if you'd like to try it out yourself, and I'll see you in the next one.